Menschenrechtsverletzungen, Morden, Folter, Hunger und so weiter und so fort. Menschen aus diesen Ländern werden heute hier sein und werden uns etwas erzählen über die Situation bei Ihnen. Möchtest du das vielleicht nochmal kurz in Englisch zusammenfassen? Nö, möchtest du nicht. Gut. Genau. Wir starten auch gleich mit einem Vertreter einer in Hamburg sehr lange schon ansässigen Gruppe, uns allen bekannt, Lampedusa in Hamburg, hierher gekommen auf der Flucht vor dem NATO-Krieg, das heißt quasi übers Mittelmeer gebombt und hier komplett rechtlos vom Hamburger Senat seit Jahren in der Luft hängen gelassen. Hierzu der erste Redebeitrag. Wir freuen uns auf den Vertreter von Lampedusa in Hamburg.
Applaus! Hallo? This is Ali Ahmed from the group Lampedusa in Hamburg, victims of NATO war 2011 in Libya. Really, just right now we receive very bad news about our group member. His name Johnny, he died yesterday here in Hamburg. So let us to come about the G20. I don't know, some people in Hamburg or some activists, they said G20. There is no something called G20. We have to say the dirty 20 countries in the world. If you look at these 20 countries individually, you will see them, those are the countries that colonized Africa, colonized Middle East, colonized Latin America, and they create more problems over the world. For example, today imagine you will see how situation in the Middle East, Iraq, Afghanistan, Iran, Syria, Yemen, other places, and also you see the conflict in Sudan, the conflict in the all African countries, economical, psychological. All these problems, and they tell us, is the G20. Nothing is called G20. We have 20 dirty countries in the world. Example, they don't like Nigerian immigrant, and they like Nigerian oil. They don't like Niger immigrant, or Niger refugees, and they like Niger uranium. They don't like Sudanese refugees and immigrant, but they like Sudanese oil. They like Sudanese gold. What they look only for their interest. And if you look deeply, those 20 countries, no only one of these countries have conflict. They don't have civil war, they don't have problems. All the conflict in Africa, Middle East, Latin America. Those people that create the world, and they don't like us to be in peace. Imagine, German citizen, Deutschland citizen, imagine your country, Germany. Germany, since 1945, up to the year 2017, you have 72 years only. You have progress, you have development, security, and all these achievements from where? From your peace. Because you have peace and we don't have the peace, we have the conflict, we have the problems. And all they create our problems by those G20 countries. For example, we have Donald Trump today in Hamburg, and many people don't like Donald Trump in Hamburg because Donald Trump deporting more refugees and against homosexual, against many things. But don't be surprised. Donald Trump politics, we have it in Hamburg here. SPD Senate, deporting many refugees, many Afghan, many people from Hamburg. Hamburg politics is in Hamburg. Donald Trump politics is in Hamburg because SPD Senate, the authority of Hamburg, they're deporting more refugees and they say they don't like Donald Trump. What's the problem of Donald Trump? Donald Trump deporting refugees and also SPD Senate deporting refugees. The same politics here in Hamburg. And they tell us this is a democracy. Okay, what is your democracy? Today I can see in Hamburg more refugees, more homeless people, jobless people, and some German citizens, they are not working, they don't have accommodation, they don't have, like we facing the refugees, the same way we are facing. The question, why the German citizens, the hopeless and the jobless people, why that didn't benefit from the democracy? What are the ills in your democracy? What is the problem in the democracy? Why the democracy didn't produce for them work? job, accommodation. This is the question we have to ask ourselves clearly about this, what we are looking for. Not that tell me that in Yemen you have democracy. No, 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 no. You have capitalism, it's correctly. You have capitalism, that is correctly. And in some way, in Germany, if you want to open the border is very good to open it. But very important, open your social system. Let anyone to benefit from the social system. More people is living in the street, no houses, no accommodation, until no insurance. To go hospital, to take medication care, to tell you go bring resident. At the same time, you talk about the democracy. Why I didn't benefit from your democracy? No go to hospital, no accommodation, no food, no all these stuffs. That's the problem. And the G20, one thing is stop supporting dictatorship in many countries. The conflict in Yemen, conflict in Iraq, conflict in Saudi Arabia, conflict today, what's happened in Libya. And we are the victims of this war. And today you tell me that here in Europe, we have G20. You don't have G20, you have 20 dirty countries in the world. Imagine today in Hamburg, Donald Trump, Erdogan, King Suleiman. What is a democracy? There is no democracy here, really. Look deeply, you will see more problems, many things that you have it. Today here in this country, you will see more people that are suffering more than us as a refugee. And you tell us that this is a democracy. And the peace, the same peace that you needed, we need the peace. If you don't like refugees and immigrants, stop support dictatorship. Stop support trade, arms and weapons. Stop produce weapons to Africa, produce weapons to Middle East, produce weapons and arms to Latin America. What we need, produce for them medicine, investment, supporting, education. That's what we need. Today we don't have a future in our kids' mind. Because why? We have war, we have problems. And the war creating by who? Creating by you here. The war creating by NATO. They tell me that NATO, there's nothing called NATO. It's a terrorist organization. They're supporting more problems, more conflict, more war in the world. And today the SPD said in Hamburg, he know about this all stuff. And he tell us he have democracy in Hamburg. There is no democracy in Hamburg. In Hamburg we have capitalism. Imagine today see Hamburg city. Last week Hamburg city is very nice city, but today police everywhere, no Uber, no Span. Because of what? Of G20. No, because of the criminal people here in Hamburg. If they are peaceful, why you not go without no security, no any reason? Because they are criminal. They have problems, and many people that don't like them. Because of that, the tie with them, good security, good accommodation. And for us, we still continue our demand. We still continue our fight until we get this right for all the refugees and human rights. Let me to come about Sudan. With Sudan, we have dictatorship called al-Bashir, and Yemen government supporting him and making with him many agreements underground with blackmail. And at the same time, you don't like Sudanese refugees in Hamburg. If you don't like that one, stop dealing with this government. What we want from you is stop just supporting dictatorship in Africa, in Middle East, in many places. In the last, I will repeat again, in Hamburg, in Europe, you don't have democracy. You have capitalism system. You have capitalism system. If you have democracy, you have to get good work, good accommodation. You in the street, you will never see homeless, jobless people. If jobless, homeless, that is finished, that means you have real democracy. The question, why the homeless, why the jobless, they didn't benefit from your democracy, they didn't benefit from the work. This is the question we have to ask ourselves. And you tell me that democracy is capitalism system. Thank you very much. This is Ali Ahmed from Lamborghini in Hamburg.